Creativity is everywhere. Painting, drawing, sculpting, architecture. But what about beyond the arts?
Can you use creativity if art isn't your thing?
Absolutely.
At Andretti Autosport, being a mechanic is not the grease pit cliche your grandparents might think of. This team of mechanics, engineers, designers, and athletes work in what I would define as part pristine, state-of-the-art garage and part extreme engineering laboratory.
Let's explore this amazing creative career.
Start your engines!
When you hear the word mechanic, what do you think of? I imagine it is not this place. I'm here at Andretti Autosport, where we're gonna meet Ryan. He's one of the mechanics here. You're gonna be blown away at what the role of a mechanic really does.
Creativity goes far beyond paints and markers. It's a unique set of skills you're required to have to excel in almost every profession. And the mechanic is no exception, especially in the world of racing.
My name is Ryan Sandlin. I am a front-end mechanic at Andretti Autosports. I changed the outside rear tire. My history growing up, like, I was all into bicycles and dirt bikes and things like that. Not so much cars and car racing. I enjoyed it, but that wasn't really my thing. But yeah, like, it was like building my bike and, you know, making it as clean and nice as possible, making sure everything worked proper maintenance, things like that. It wasn't like about racing or tinkering with cars then. Like, it was really after high school when I was like, okay, I actually enjoy it now. This is fun. It's different, but a lot of the mentality is the same. The people that are at the track, you know, you see the fun part, like out on pit lane, doing pit stops during the race. Like, that's the enjoyable part, but the harder, more technical stuff is definitely back in the garage area.
Like, oh my God, what is this? I don't want to stigmatize what I think of a garage mechanic, but
dirty,
this is like
rags, stuff like that. Like,
yeah, this is on almost surgical level. It's crazy. It's cool. Give me a little backstory, like, why are you working on this particular car?
Oh, this is my car. This is Kyle Kirkwood's car. This car is the workhorse. This is what you see pretty much every weekend right here.
It's exciting to be in here. I mean, it's just like, there's That's a lot wild. Going on.
You take a look around and people don't realize like how big it is. Like, it's pretty neat to see all the banners, those are all race wins from different series within the Andretti name.
Man,
it's
crazy.
It's a lot.
It's hard to overstate just how massive and comprehensive this garage is. There are dozens of stations, from engines to fabrication, welding to wings. There's even an area for practicing pit stops.
Here at Andretti Racing, checking out they're doing some pit stop practice. Check this out.
For this crew, saving even a few precious seconds during a stop can make the difference between winning and losing.
That's gotta be like nerve-wracking, just curious. Like, I mean, after 9 years, you've kind of gotten used to it, but like, once they're out there racing and you're like, oh crap, I know I did my job, but still, like.
We joke about that a lot. It's what I always try to tell like the new guys, like, listen, if you have to check it three times, check it three
times.
Just do
it, yeah.
I'd rather you check it that extra time and find something rather than, you know, pulling the car out of a wall.
Yeah, that's just overall good life advice we're getting here. Yeah.
Sure.
Creativity at its core is problem solving. Finding solutions to complex problems in seconds is at the heart of being a race mechanic.
That's the best one I got.
Hey man, thank you so much. Seriously, like, getting a small glimpse into the incredible job you have and just hearing how you led up to that, man. It's really a great story. It's really inspirational.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Yeah, well, I mean, just walking around here with you, I'm like, I'd work here. Like, this is a really cool place to work.
Might be hiring, you never
know. Right.
We're here in Indianapolis, Indiana at, of course, IMS, the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. And we're actually gonna go catch up with Ryan, the mechanic that we've been working with, as he and his team are preparing the car for race day. Follow me.
Hey,
So we're here in Gasoline Alley. We're actually in all the garages. There are several of them. All these bays are all Andretti Motorsports. They've been testing on the track, and now they're coming in here and making tons of minor micro adjustments, which you would not think are very important, but all those little adjustments mean a big deal on the track. Things down to like suspension, coil, moving things around to create better airflow. It's kind of amazing to see how his creative brain is making all these adjustments in the moment, and then they're gonna go back out for another big 30-minute run just to make more adjustments, getting ready for race day. So Ryan, tell me, now that we were at Andretti, you know, getting ready and whatnot, now we're actually trackside. So what kind of things are you doing today on the track with the team?
Early on, we do a lot of car compares. So basically all of our cars will go out, set up the exact same way.
Okay.
Go out, get a run, see where we're at individually. And then that way we know what car has what speed.
When I saw you making like just micro adjustments, like, you know, on the track and then back at the garage. So just a lot of fine tuning.
Absolutely. Yeah. We're together so much, we work together so much, we all do the same things each time, so I know what, you know, Nate's doing, I know what Ryan's doing, I know what Brian's doing, like it's like a poetry in motion.
Yeah. For me, standing back, that's what it looks like. You guys all just know exactly, everybody knows kind of what part to work on, exactly how to manipulate it.
Yep.
It's cool, just to see all that happen in the moment.
It's a lot of experience, just working together. These cars are loud.
The ultimate goal is when you win a race, like knowing that you built that car and you put in all the effort and the time and you executed in the pits, you did everything you possibly could and it paid off. You win, you know, like there's nothing better than that.
It's been awesome to just to get to step into like your life and just see, you know, how the role of a mechanic is just, I mean, it's so intense and so
there's
broad.
A lot. There's a lot to it.
Engineering and mechanics, design, absolutely, all to come together. It's
absolutely
crazy.
There's not a lot of people you can say, hey, I work in racing, this is what I do. It's fun to bring in a new guy who's never done it or year one, and then it's like, you know, you show up to Indy and there's 350,000 people screaming and hollering. It's a very rewarding job, it's fun, and there's a lot of opportunities once you do get in, as long as you have the, you know, the desire to want to do it and the passion to learn and think and find what works for you, you know. Put a resume together, you know. What's it gonna hurt? Take it to a team and drop it off and see what happens. Call and talk to somebody. See what you need to do to get yourself in the door. Take the step, try to, you know, go for it.
Now that you know that being a mechanic is this awesome blend of high tech and hands-on mechanic, what do you do next? We're here at Ivy Tech at their Automotive Center, which is state of the art. I'm gonna go show you what it takes to train to become an auto mechanic. Come follow me. Well, tell me, what do you do here? And then tell me more about the facility and what's offered at Ivy Tech.
So we have our regular automotive program that, you know, exists in the main shop. We have our heavy truck diesel program, and then we offer kind of introductory to motorsports class.
Oh, cool.
Program over there. So
I love automotive right now because it's such a blend of like manual, like old school, but then it's also lots of high tech equipment.
Yep.
That looks like you guys have lots of that.
We're teaching them all the way to diagnosing, you know, pretty epic electrical problems, trying to get them ready for the world of electric cars and all the diagnostic
Yeah, exactly. That's awesome. There's still something just awesome about, like, one, the creative process of problem solving, but the other, just hands-on. I love tech, obviously, but then I love building, making with my hands, and manipulating. So, like, it's just something that I don't see people appreciate about the trades that still exist.
Working with your hands.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we have plenty of working with your hands.
And by the way, this place is pristine, which is one thing I've noticed about lots of, you know, shops, even at Andretti Racing. It is not whatever dirty, nasty, smoke-filled, whatever facility. That is not what's going on here.
There is a lot of expectation from customers these days to have clean technicians and clean shops. They expect that, you know, that white glove type of service.
It sounds like they have opportunities to find careers almost probably right out side or just as they finish up the program?
I even encourage them to get a job at the very beginning. And I tell them, this is what you want to do, you want to get in the industry, start now.
Yeah.
Start now, working at a shop, learning when you're there, it helps you learn here. And I got students that are graduating a year out and they're making over $100,000 a year. a year after
that. That's crazy. Okay, what are my next steps? If I'm like, man, I want to learn more about getting involved in one of these programs or signing up, like, what would you suggest?
As far as coming here, the easiest thing is just show up.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what you know. I got students in this class that, you know, couldn't tell you where the engine was in a car.
Right, right.
And then I got students that are working at shops. A lot of the kids, the young people today, they don't have that experience working with their parents or grandparents in the driveway. They only have a passion. So we take that passion and we try and turn it into a career.
Man, keep it up. Like, I love what you guys are doing here, and what an awesome opportunity that people can jump right into. Like,
yep.
You see it, like, the man, the jobs are there, the opportunity's there, just do it.
Absolutely.